Hey guys, this is Shinx and today we are back in another Bleach Mobile 3D video. So in this video, I want to be doing the Urukiora gameplay and showcase to see kind of how good he is and whether from this gameplay whether you guys want to pull for him or not. So basically, how to get him, it will be the through the exchanging of the Nail fragments. So you go to the Nail banner and the trade bag. It costs 1 Nail fragment and 100 gems, I think. Yeah, so you need a total of 5000 gems and 50 Nail fragments. So video on how to do it, you can check it out on my Nail summons video. So let's just hop into it. So my Nail is not, my Urukiora is not like the best yet because it only has like 2 bonds at the moment. I'm slowly working on rank 8, so to unlock his 3rd bond, because it'll be better if you have 3 bonds because you get a lot of extra stat boost. So yeah. So at the moment, he has his basic attributes will be okay. So his skills, his skill 1 will be Cero, which is a chance to slow down the enemy. Not that great of a status, but it's better than no status. So skill 2 will be Coral. So it's a instant move to perform a multi attack and return, heal yourself and a chance to weaken the enemy. So this move is very similar to the Dangai Ichigo's skill 1 where he jumps to the enemy and do quite a bit of attacks. So this attack is actually quite slow, so you will still get attacked by the enemy while doing casting this skill, so watch out. So good thing is you can heal a bit by using this skill. Next will be after liberation. When after liberation, his skill 1 becomes a moon lens. It's called moon lens. So it throws a light spear, as you all know, in the enemy and deals, and the status is also the same, slow and damage. Okay, next will be his moonlit array. This one will be, I believe it's a much faster, it's much faster than his before liberation. So it has the same chance of weakening enemy, heal yourself, and this animation looks very very cool. So as if you use him as an assist, what you can do is you get instead of the slow status, you have a chance to weaken the enemy. This is decent because if you use it as this, you can weaken the enemy for you to deal more damage for your main. So bonds wise, he has quite decent bond. Like example, he has 3 attack bonds, but the characters are quite specific and it's not easy to get. So the first one will be Dangai Ichigo, where you get the attack bond. Next will be the Grimmjow. So then next, this is the R rank Inoue. Then there's the Arranka Aizen Baby Nail, and also the SR Ichigo. So very very decent bonds because you don't have to specifically get that 3. If you take a look at the Toshiro, you only have 3 options, and so if you miss one of them, you cannot, if you don't have any one of them, you cannot really make him useful. So yeah, but and take note that all these are most of these are SSR bonds besides the 1R bond and SR bonds. So SSR bonds are generally more useful because of their increase in stats compared to being SR and R. So yeah. Okay. Then for his third skill will be Luz de la Luna. Sorry for the mispronunciation. So it's an AoE attack with Moon Lens, the skill 1 I believe. Then it deals damage, increases the teammate's crit damage for 30% for 8 seconds and deal extra damage. So not bad for a third skill because it helps to boost your teammate's damage. Then at the moment I have only 30k attack because of my the skill books, they aren't really leveled, don't really have enough EXP books. So next, without further ado, let's just jump into some events. So I want to show you guys the inner selection, where it's a decent place to show off PvP. So yeah, let's hope I can do decent. So the opponent is using Baby Nell. So Baby Nell, she looks like a low level Nell. Baby Nell has a shield, okay, this one was pretty easy because he didn't level up his Nell, I believe, too much. Next. So what I usually like to do in PvP is I like to use the Toshiro skill because of his range. Then because I have Momo, I'll cast. Usually when the opponent sees you do the Toshiro assist, right, they will just use Shunko. So then once they Shunko, I'll use Nell. Okay, this will be his skill too. Take some time. Oh my god, he's using, I want to be very careful because I don't want to get hit. Oh my god, that was really good. No, I don't want to die. Oh no, damn it, I lost to the Kenpachi. He has like, I think Kenpachi is actually decent enough to deal with if you stay out of range and like don't get stunned, but obviously I screwed up just now, so yeah. Okay, next will be Toshiro. This is kind of an even better, so let's just see how we do. Okay. Oh, he did. Yeah. So yeah, the good thing about Urukiora is his skill 1 and skill 2, right, has two you can use it 2 times each, so you can kind of spam skills a lot. Then like he's because you can use more skills a lot, right, you can potentially dish more damage. So this Kenpachi is kind of weak, as weaker than the previous one. So as you can see, even though I missed the first skill because he used Shunpo, right, I can still use the other one and still hunt him down. Oh, this guy is using, oh, Nell. Okay, let's just see how I do. So I kind of like this game mode a lot, besides the selection. Okay, so no. Oh shit, no, I didn't. Oh my god, the shield though. Oh damn it. Okay, the Nell is actually very strong. Okay, the reason why I didn't make Nell is because I'm missing the Aizen bond for her. So as you know, I kind of like, Oh, it's my associate guy. Give me chance, please. Oh no, he's level 93. What the hell? Okay, okay, let's just play it fair, boys. Oh no, 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 no. What? 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 Ooh. Ha, crap. Oh no 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 no. Oh yes, let me heal. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, okay, I healed up, healed up, healed up. Okay, I wanna charge up my resurrect to show. Okay, nice. Okay, so this will be his resurrection. His skill 2 will look so much cooler. Then his lens is this. Oh. Die! Oh my god, I don't even know how I won that. Like, it, from the level wise, he was like level 94 and I was only at level 80. And he has like quite a lot of HP. I think he misplayed on his part. Come on, game. Matching a fair rival. You call that fair? Okay, is this the same nail? I felt like it was the same nail. Okay, I did not summon for baby nail, so yeah. Okay, this was not fair. So the reason why I want him is because he's kind of my one of my favorite characters. Like, I mean, come on, he's like everybody's favorite character because he's so cool and his resurrection has wings, which is like I'm a major fan. Then, oh my god, why do I keep calling it resurrection? In this game, it's liberation. So my bad. His skill actually is very very cool. After he used his liberation, then especially the skill 2. So oh, why is there a level 40 guy here? Interesting. Okay, so for partner, right, I'm using the con ban partner. Then he buffs a bit of crit damage. I don't really have any other decent partner. I'm trying to aim for Zangetsu, but at the moment I'm still very low to play Tozen, and I don't want to be a burden to my team, because like, you know the feeling when you guys were like so close and because you aren't doing that much damage, like the whole your team cannot really oh shit, okay. Your team cannot really go to the boss. Oh no no no. He landed. Oh shit, no no no. I should run. Okay, okay, I need to play this right. Okay, I lost this. No. Oh no, damn it. Okay. Definitely I misplayed. I kind of screwed up a bit. So let me just try again. So some of them say that he gets kind of outclassed by his new version of the Urukiora, so basically he's not as a viable option. Then whether if you want a summon, I would say no, I shouldn't have used the skill 2, not when he's power up. Oh no, damn it. Okay, so if you are thinking whether you want a summon, I would say the reason why you want to summon this banner is because of Nell instead. So Then if you're not a huge fan of Urukiora, right, what I can advise you to do is to wait and summon for the Shinji, where Aranka Aizen will be back as trade back. So okay, so kind of screwed up that part. Let me see if I can find a decent Serete opponent. Okay, so I mean, I can probably destroy that decent level. Just now you saw that 860, I think. But I want to try for a bit of a challenge. Okay, give me a moment. Okay, so this guy, he's much, I would say much higher than me. So I'll just see how good is he like on auto battle, I would say. Oh no, they have liberation at the start. I might be on the losing end. Come on, come on, come on. Rukiora, get your liberation. Oh yes, 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 got it, got it. But whether can we win? Oh, 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 we won, we won. No, 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 we didn't win. So close, so close. Please, please, please. Oh my god, that was damn close. Thanks to the Momo. So if you guys haven't summoned for Momo, or basically her banner is not out yet, I can recommend you guys going for her because of how of her healing. So if you are close, this is decent because for the invasion of the Serete invasion, right, basically the event mission, right, you can actually heal the red color crystal if you are, if the enemy is there, is near at the crystal, and you use your skill and it hits the enemy, like how to say, when she does the healing skill, right, it's a circle. So if the red crystal is near the circle, the crystal will get healed also. So it's a very very strong, and also obviously it heals you, which means you can sustain better. And just now if you see, the healing actually helped me quite a bit. Like without the healing, I'll probably have lost. Okay, so let's just try, since it's my last attempt, I'll try for a bit harder. He most likely have the enrage at the start. So oh yes, he does. Enrage at the start. If you wanna ask me how to get it, basically you need your, if I'm not wrong, you need all of your characters to be rank 7 to get full rage bar when you start. So definitely it will be a strength for, who's that, the Toshiro, because it will be a strength for Toshiro because he can freeze enemy like very very at the start of battle. So when he's frozen, obviously you Urukiora has his liberation and he can start dishing a lot of damage. So I have 20k of that, of this thing, what's this thing called, gold coins. Okay, so I want to go ahead and get the advanced paint to get a bit of extra stats. So what's this? Okay, so for those who have him, right, a good accessory that you want to use is the frost rain that you can get from the shop itself. So you need 6,000 gems to unlock the frost rain. So from my guild, my associate leader, he basically say that which is this Tails guy, so he say that he does more DPS with frost rain than the Onibi. So yeah, definitely you can try that. And he also uses the another tip that I heard is basically for an assist character, right, you want someone with a lot of bonds, because game modes like the PvE where your assist is basically just the assist skill, right, what it does is their stats will kind of give it to your main character. So that's how you do extra damage, get extra stats. So yeah, the reason why they are using the Yamamoto is because they have like, Yamamoto has like 4 attack bonds, I believe, which is very very insane if you can get him to high level. So yeah. Okay, next I want to show you guys the punishment force contest. It's just basically okay, today is not Urikiora, but let's just see. So if you still do not know this, the punishment force contest is basically a 3v3 version of the inner selection. So very very fun game mode. Oh no. Okay, so another one way to tell whether you are fighting bots or not is just now during the loading screen. If you see someone in front of you, most likely is another player. So if not, it's a bot. Oh no 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 no. Oh no no no. Oops, I got destroyed. Okay, I should have kept my distance because Urikiora is a distance character. Can my team win? No, I don't think they can. Okay, sorry. I lost this one. Come on, come on, Ishin, just die already. Come on, just die, just die. Oh my god. No, yeah, he's dead. Okay. So I did quite a bit of damage, but okay, let's just try again. So one thing that I heard that Urukiora is very good at is basically the Soul Reaper Brawl, because of how good, how many skills he can spam. Oh, that was a... That is definitely a... Oh, there's a... I was wondering like who was attacking me. What? Oh, what the hell? Oh, I pressed quit, damn it. Damn! Oh my god. Did I press it? Oh, I think I accidentally pressed it. Okay, so I cocked up and I lost. Okay, let's just try this again. Okay, so the theme for today is actually Agile. So one more thing that I learned that for this punishment force is if you use 2 of the bonus character, I think you can get 2 boxes of the talent pills instead of 1. Oh my god, it's him again, damn it. I want to kill him first because he kind of like does more damage. Okay, run, hit and run technique. No, no, stop waking me, damn it. Heal up a bit. So I wanna kill this Uichi. Oh, somehow I won. Yes, yes, yes. So basically Urukiora is kind of more about spamming the skills. And talent wise, oh yeah, I didn't go through the talent. So I can't remember who is his talent character, but I'll get to it later. But for his talent skill, right, I recommend just going for the cooldown reduction on the weapon skill. Then, and also go for the damage. Then for his bond characters, right, just basically just keep doing that. So you get extra cooldown for your skill. Oh my god, why am I keep playing with him? But it's okay, let's just try to do. Damn. Stop. Stop. Oh my god, he go into resurrection. Come on, come on, come on, dodge, dodge, dodge.
No, damn it.
Oh, I probably lost this one. Okay, okay, so let me just go through a bit of his talent first before I continue trying this. Okay, so his talent character is actually, oh yeah, Grimmjow and Danga Ichigo. So the Danga Ichigo part is not easy because obviously you need to pull for Danga Ichigo to unlock to get the extra 10 points. So like, if you want to plan to make your Ulquiorra pretty decent, you might want to try for the Danga Ichigo because of the Danga Ichigo is also a bond for the Ulquiorra, so you can basically become better to get the 3 attack boost as a bond. You need Ulquiorra, Aranka Aizen and Grimmjow. Yeah, so whether you should pull for him, he's a very very good DPS character, so but I can't really show you guys yet because my Ulquiorra is still kind of bad. Okay, okay, I want to run a bit. Kill here. Okay, destroyed one. Now, oh no. Oh, but it's okay. So as you can see, I did like quite a lot of damage compared to the bots, obviously. So in PvE, right, he will obviously be a beast because PvE most likely you will not die, so you also want to do a lot of damage so you can clear the boss easily, etc. So Ulquiorra is definitely a good option. PvP wise, besides Aranka Aizen, right, he is also one of the demons in the PvP. So like usually when people see, right, they will be kind of scared of him. Okay, then the reason why is because of his skill tree. Like if my skill tree was a purple or blue skill book, right, I would have basically like one-shotted the enemy instead. Oh sh- no 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 no. So, and also if you have enraged at the start, right, it will even help him better in PvP because of his damage. Then also the you saw how his attacks, his skills gets better once he liberates, so you will want to use him as a when he's liberated. Then you can spam 5 skills instead of 3. So even if you miss one, right, you have a, how to say, you have another chance to redeem yourself, I would say. So then also another thing is because he has two tries for his skills, right, basically what you can, but when you use finish your one whole set of skill, right, most likely you will have another one that will be charging already, so it kind of shows how much he can spam as a character. And he's a really really worth character that if you build well enough, right, he can pretty much last you quite some time in the future. And also, Attack Nell is also very the adult Nell is also a very very cool character. Then, yeah. So, but I have to emphasize this again. If you have only two options to go for, whether the adult Nell banner or the Shinji medal, Shinji banner, basically, adult Nell with Uruk or Shinji with Arranka. So, I would say to just, you might want to go for Shinji because his skills is actually a counter to the Arranka Aizen. So yeah. Okay, this guy is a character, right? I wasn't paying attention. Okay, but most likely he's dead. Oh yeah, then his skills is not the, it kind of has kind of decent range, so you can, you want to stay far behind and just destroy the people. And he has 3 dodge, 3 shunko, so definitely one of the better advantages. So yeah, I was talking about this talent pew chest. So if you use the bonus characters, right, like maybe Green Zhao and Sajin, right, instead of getting 1 only per match that you play, you can get 2, I believe. So yeah. Then that's it for this video. Please leave a like and consider subscribing if you want more weekly Bleach Mobile 3D content. Then if you wanna ask, like, look for a place to if you have any information you wanna ask, like future banners, etc., you can join the Discord group link below in the description. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you.